back to my channel. I'm Matt, this is Prime Analog Records, and what I wanted to tell you today is I finally found a grail that I've been looking for. It's been on my watch list on Discogs for probably a year. And every time I see it and it suggests that I get it, it's over $200. And it's got, and it's in Europe. So it hasn't been available here. And finally, the other day I saw on my watch list that it was available, and it was $40, and it was in this country. What I'm talking about is this right here, Jeff Beck. Unbelievable. I mean, this is such a great album. Everything about it, it sounds amazing. It really looks cool too. Check this out. So it's pretty wild, but anyway, what I wanted to do today is I wanted to show you guys my my meatloaf recipe, and it's very, very simple, although I make it a little bit crazy, but it is simple to put together. It just takes a little time, but anyway, you start out with ground beef. You have the ground beef, it goes into a mixing bowl. I've got probably right at 3 pounds, and that goes in, and then this goes in. Super simple, the savory herb, stovetop stuffing, and it's super simple, super simple. Is we dump it all together in here like this, you know, with the meat, and then you take a I usually use this one or just regular onion soup mix, and I use one packet, not both the packets, just one packet. Two would be a little too salty, but you're not going to have to really do much seasoning to this because the seasonings are in the stuffing and in this mix here. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna mix this all together in this bowl. And what I do, I put, just for a little bit of smoky flavor in there, I put some smoked paprika in there, which is this right here. And I put probably about a couple of teaspoons. Remember, you're seasoning a big amount here, a big amount of meat. So anyway, I put some red pepper flake in, about this much. That's to surprise you when you hit one of those seeds when you're eating it. Also, I put a little bit of chipotle pepper in, like that, about that much, which is probably a little bit more. It's probably about the same size, probably a teaspoon. Put some onion salt in. I mean, onion powder, not salt. It's because you don't want to put any more salt in there than you have to. Some garlic powder goes in. That's probably 3 teaspoons. Don't forget black pepper. So that's not going to work. Like I said, it looks like I'm putting a lot of stuff in. I'm really not. I mean, this is what this looks like here. And then I put a little bit of milk in there, not very little, probably half a cup, like that. You notice that I'm not really measuring anything. It really doesn't have to be, but there's no other way to do it. You got to get your hands into it. Oh, also one more thing. I put a squirt or two of mustard in it too, because that brightens the taste a little bit. All right, so what you do is you just get in there and you start working this meat through this, like this. I try to get this done before I put the wet too much wet on there, in there, outside of the milk. All right, so I've mixed it all up. So now what we got to do is we're going to put a couple of eggs in it. I put the eggs in, and then I put a little bit of milk in there to disperse this a little bit better. The milk goes in there a little bit. What we're gonna do, we're gonna whisk that all together. I'm trying to not make a big giant mess at the same time. I don't have to be crazy about it, but anyway, that goes in. And then we're gonna go back through this again and mix this all up. Okay, now that the egg mixture is together with the meat all together, the seasoned meat, which remember we put smoked paprika, put some red pepper flake, a little bit of onion powder, chipotle powder, and garlic powder. And remember we put one packet of this, and one packet equals this. I mean, it's one packet, not, it comes with two, but you don't want to use two because it's too much, it'll be too much sodium, and it's just too much. But anyway, so what we're going to do right now, I'm going to show you the next step to this. This goes in the refrigerator because I leave it in there for about 30 minutes or so because it'll incorporate and soften the hardness of the stovetop stuffing, because it's going to reduce pretty good in this, and you'll see the next step right now. The next step is that we're going to line this Bundt pan. It's a Bundt, it's for cakes generally, and we're going to line this with bacon. I'll show you that process in a minute. The first thing, make sure that you put, PAM or a nonstick spray inside here. Or you could really be crazy and do butter all over it. But that's what we're gonna do right now. I noticed the other day when I was buying bacon is that they've actually made these smaller now. It's actually, when you think you're buying a pound, it looks like it is, but it's not. It's 12 ounces. So they're really starting to really piss me off about this. And also what they did is they made these shorter. So it's going to be difficult for me to do how I'm doing it, but I'm still going to do it. But you make sure that you overlap the bacon as you put it on here. What you're going to do is you're going to try to make it so it comes. So it comes up to the fluted area here. You can see it right here. And it doesn't matter so much about rolling over the top because we're gonna fix that too. But you wanna make sure that you get it all the way down on the bottom. So it's all the way across the bottom. So it's gonna go across there like this. I'm gonna see if I can show you. See how it is right there? And what we're gonna do is the meatloaf that we just made is going to go in there. It's going to go into that and adhere to the shape of this pan. So I'll be back in a second. All right, so as you can see, I have it overlapping. It runs all the way around. And if you get the long bacon like it's supposed to be, it's like this. This is the long bacon. This is a pound. But anyway, what you want to do is you want to make it go through that and make sure everyone is laying over each other. So they're sort of basically, there's no gaps in there. And I've done a pretty good job of that. There's one little one right there that I need to close up. But reason why you want this is because you'll get bacon in every single bite, basically. And so there it goes there. This goes here like that. And see how I've laid them up here on the top here. You can see that. And those all, when I fill this with the meatloaf, we'll put all that back over. And I'll show you the next procedure here. All right, so this isn't rocket science. That, also, you're supposed to, I didn't tell you, You're supposed to turn your oven on before you start all this procedure, so you'd be ready to slide it in, but it's no big deal. But it's 375, and we're going to put it in for, you know, probably about close to an hour, but we want to take a look at it halfway through. But anyway, you just start pulling the mixture out like this, and you just lay it in there, just like this. Lay it into that gap, and it's pretty simple. I mean, so I'll be back in a second when I've got it all done. Try to push it down like I'm doing here. Let's see it better here. Try to push it down so it's all uniform across and you don't have any gaps or any, because you're gonna have to put this in handfuls. You can't just dump it there because you're kind of being gentle so you don't mess up your bacon that you laid down. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to get all this level and no air pockets in there. And then what you just do is you go around and you just take the bacon here and you bring it back over like this. You're gonna take it right from here and over back there, so this way and this way. And you know, these short ones, they screwed me over because I'm making this no matter what. I just kind of go with it. But I was hoping that these short ones would reach, and they're making it, but it's supposed to, the way it's supposed to work, which it doesn't always, but you can roll it over like this, and you won't see, like this one here, and you won't see any meatloaf. It's kind of guarding it, and it's kind of basting it the whole time, so kind of interesting, but you'll see at the end, it doesn't matter because it's gonna sit on this end anyway, and we're gonna turn it over. So I'm gonna slide this into the oven, and we'll check back on it in a little bit. I try to bring it to, I think it's about 165 is what I've, internal temperature, and I take that with a rapid thermometer. So we'll check back in a little bit, and I'll show you the rest. All right, this is a tricky point. So I pulled it out. We've got the internal temperature to 165, and the tricky part is here, because you need to have barbecue gloves or something like that. That would help tremendously. What we have to do is we have to, after it's cooled a little bit, I mean, just give it a couple of minutes, let the steam and everything come off of it. And then what you want to do is you need to have, like I said, these barbecue gloves like this. What you're going to do is you're going to pick this up and you're going to drain the fat off of it. This is what it looks like right now, right here. But I'm going to drain the fat off of it into the sink. Be very careful not to burn yourself, because this is going to be very, very hot, as you can imagine. All right, now what we're going to do is we're going to do a flip, is what I call it. What we're going to do is I'm going to take, this is important. An important step, because what we're going to do is we're going to take this, put this down, put this on top of it, obviously the face down, and we're going to turn it over one solid motion like that. All right, there it comes out. And here you can see the way that looks. It's like that. It's pretty wild, right? Well, we're not done yet, because now we want to turn our oven on broil, and we're going to put it under there and let that crisp up really good. All right, it's out of the broiler, and this is what it looks like when we're done. And what's amazing about it is that it slices so amazingly. You can get bacon in every single slice. And what I really like to do is I like to let it cool off, and then I slice it, and that way I've got two parts. that I can put it flat in a pan, and I don't have to put any grease or anything in the pan. Just put it in a dry pan and sear a side off, and then sear another side off. You turn it, and it's so amazing because it's got a crunch to it, and the flavors are all there, and it's pretty wild, and it's seems like a little bit more of a process than usual, just throwing stuff into a pan, but it's actually worth it, I can tell you. And in the well here, just on presentation, what you want to put, what I usually put is mashed potatoes in there. So when somebody goes and gets a wedge, they can get some mashed potatoes in there too. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed that. We'll talk about records next time. Thanks for watching, and all my best.